In this lesson, we're going to learn exactly what it is that makes up a game. However, before we do that, we need to establish the intuitive notion of what is known as a set. For our purposes, when we hear the word set, all we need to think of is a bucket. So what do buckets do? We'll call this bucket A. Buckets hold things. They are containers. So for example, the set A might have inside of it the numbers 1 and 2. It might have inside of it the symbol star. But most importantly, a bucket can also contain other buckets. So we can say that the set B is inside of the set A. If I want to refer to the items inside of A, I call them elements. So for example, I say star is an element of A, or the bucket B, the set B, is an element of A. Again, for our purposes, when we hear the word set, all we need to think about is a container that can possibly have other containers. Okay, good. Now we can define a game. So we define a game G as a set. I use curly braces to denote a set with three elements, P, A, and U. P stands for players, A for actions, and U for utility, which I'll sometimes refer to as payoffs. I'll now discuss each in turn. So the players is very simple. P is also a set that denotes the decision makers in a game. So for example, if two players or two people are playing chess, it can be Jose and Maria. They're playing chess. However, decision makers don't have to be human. For example, robots make decisions. You can think of an automatic self-driving car making a decision. So the game can be between robot 1, robot 2, and robot 3. More generically, I'll always or typically refer to players as just the set where the players are P1, player 1, player 2, up into player N. So a game that has N players is, surprisingly enough, just called an N-player game. Okay? So players, P is a set that lists the decision makers in a game. Okay, how about actions? So A is a set with elements, we'll say little a1, little a2, little an, where each little a denotes what each player can do. So for example, we can think of a two-player game. So players is P1 and P2. And the action set will just be little a1, little a2, where a1 says that player 1, his move, can be either up or down. That's his action. And player 2 can either go left or right. So the set capital A of actions tells us what each player can do in the game. Finally, utility. So U, the utility, is also a set with elements little u1, little u2, un, where each element is actually a function. The function takes as an input the actions of all players and outputs the reward for a player. So for example, u1 is a function. It might take, it says that if player 1 plays up and player 2 plays left, then, remember, I'm using this example here with up and left, then player 1 earns a reward of 2. However, we can also say that if player one plays up and player two plays right, then player one earns a reward of -7. Each little u in the set big U gives a utility function for each player. So there we have it. A game is a set with players, actions, and utilities. It says who is making a decision, what decision can they make, and what reward do they get as a result of the decision of all players. In the next lesson, we'll learn how to represent a game in a simple matrix form known as the normal form game.